So the deal was made for 50,000 guilders. But the mayor and his unscrupulous council had no intention of paying the Pied Piper. The 50,000 guilders in the treasury would be melted down for the golden chimes. And as for the piper, they'd worry about that when the time was riper. That night, at the rise of the moon, the Pied Piper set to his task. He blew a few notes on his pipe, and gradually the squeaking of the rats became a muttering, and the muttering grew to a grumbling, and the grumbling grew to a mighty rumbling, and out of each house the rats came tumbling. All sorts of rats, families of rats, brothers, sisters, husbands, wives, followed the piper for their lives. From street to street he piped advancing, and step by step they followed dancing. As the music mounted, the windows of the homes were flung open, and faces appeared staring in disbelief at the street. Doors flew open and people started to run out, but suddenly turned and pulled back, staring down at the ground, repelled and at the same time fascinated. Strangely enough, while the parents were all aware of this music for the rats, the children couldn't hear it at all. Just as the parents couldn't hear the music the piper first played for the children when he arrived in Hamelin, the mayor and his council ran to the council hall windows and stared at the scurrying rats. More and more and more rats were attracted by the piper's music until it all seemed that the rats in creation had joined an army, the general of which was the Pied Piper. At last they came to the riverfront where the piper stopped. All the rats scurried right past his feet. They plunged off the wharf into the river, where they all perished.